If you cast your mind back to September last year, you might remember that I installed a smart bird box on the side of my house. I bought the Birdfy Nest with my own money in the hope that we'd get a couple of birds moving, lay some eggs, and we could watch the whole nesting cycle on camera. Well, join me for an update on how the Birdfy Nest performed over winter, and keep watching to find out whether we had any visitors or not. So let's just remind ourselves of what the Birdfy Nest is. It's a bamboo bird box with two cameras, one mounted on the outside watching the entrance, another inside looking down into the box itself. It comes with a solar panel to keep the batteries charged and multiple entrance guards to help you target birds of different sizes. The latest version of it also includes a metal guard to stop larger birds pecking the wood away, but mine didn't include that. The cameras will detect motion and record clips to the cloud, which you can view in the app. It also uses AI to identify the birds in the videos, which is very useful if you don't have a clue. If you want to know more about the specs, then check out my original review video. I'll stick a link to that down in the description. We're going to take a look at how it coped with its first winter, so let's go outside and have a look. So hopefully you can see the Birdfy Nest behind me. Now, it doesn't appear to have weathered brilliantly over winter. There's quite a bit of black mould growing on it. I'll put a close-up on the screen right now so as you can see that. I have read online that you can sand it down and paint it so as it looks brand new again, but I'm not sure I'm going to do that. I think I might just see how it goes. If you look at the camera there on the outside, you can see that there's a lot of spider's webs around it, so I'm going to have to clean that up. And let's open it up and have a look inside. Now, a little bit of mould there on the door, as you can see, so that's not great. There are quite a few spider's webs inside. You're not going to be able to see that on camera, I don't think. But all of the electronics look perfectly fine. There doesn't look to be any damage to that at all. So you can see the solar panel there mounted on the side of my house. It's kind of silhouetted against the sun because it is south facing and I'm behind it. But that solar panel runs all the way into the bird box just here, and I haven't had to charge this at all. So this has survived the entire winter purely on solar power going into the battery. Right then, let's clean some of these spiders' webs away so as we can get a nice clear view, because the spiders' webs do actually set off the motion detection quite a lot, and it thinks that the fluffy spiders' webs are actually birds' feathers. So that can be a bit annoying at times. So you can see this huge Wi-Fi antenna here. Now, that's given me a really strong connection to the internet. Admittedly, my Wi-Fi access point is just on the other side of this wall, about 3 to 4 meters away maximum, and it's given perfect connection. I have read online that a few people on Facebook groups have had connectivity issues, but I suspect that that's because they're trying to get a Wi-Fi connection to a router that is on the other side of their house or something, and it's probably struggling a bit. Okay, let's close this up. I think I'm going to take this down at some point and give it a good clean so as it's ready for the next season, and possibly even replace this bit here with a smaller one. I don't know, I'll seek some advice off other bird lovers.
So what about visitors then? Well, within a couple of weeks of installing it, it was visited by a starling. Mr. Starling visited us a few times along with a wren and a blue tit. And because I'm rubbish at identifying birds, I know what they were because the app told me. None of them went inside the nest box at all though. They were just inspecting the outside.
Thank you.
then, at the start of January, along came a new guy, a great tit. This guy was very keen and visited a few times a week, even going inside to have a look around. As we went into March, it was visiting the nest box almost every day, and we were confident that we'd have a little family of birds in there very soon. And then, on the 24th of March, he visited us for the last time. In fact, that was the last time any bird visited the box. Nobody moved in at all. No eggs to watch hatching, no baby birds to watch leaving the nest, nothing. The only thing we actually saw was a spider that moved in. So look, I'm very disappointed, of course, but it's not the nest box's fault. It has performed excellently and captured all of the important moments, and crucially, it never dropped off the network and never needed charging. I guess what I'll have to do now is give it a good clean over the summer, ready for next year. I might even fit the smallest entrance guard just in case that's what put the blue tits off this year, because they were very interested early on. Birdfy also now have a smaller nest box available called the Nest Polygon, which has a single camera inside and a built-in solar panel. So this could be an interesting alternative, but overall I'm pretty happy with my purchase of the full-size Birdfy Nest. I'm not a bird Right. Sorry to interrupt here, but only a couple of days after recording this video, I noticed that one of the LEDs on the camera inside the nest box was flickering on and off a lot. I noticed it because on the recorded footage one night, you could see the light flickering inside the box, and that was visible on both cameras too. I reckon this would put off any birds from moving in when it's like this. I've tried powering the camera off and on again, but I think it's a physical hardware fault. I've contacted NetView support to ask if they could send me a replacement camera so as I can swap it over, and they actually got back to me within a few hours. After providing them with a bit more information, they said they were sending me out an entirely new replacement Birdfy Nest. Now remember, I did purchase this with my own money. This video is not sponsored, and Birdfy support don't know that I'm making this video, so there's no special treatment. Hopefully the new nest box will arrive soon, and I'll put a note down in the description if there are any problems with it. Anyway, back to the other Ollie and whatever rubbish he was talking about. I'm not a bird watcher or twitcher or whatever they call themselves, but I did have a lot of fun over winter and in the early spring watching the videos of the birds checking out the nest. And I have to admit, it was very exciting when I got an alert on my phone to tell me that it had detected something. Anyway, if you're interested in one of these, then I'll put some links down in the description to where you can buy them from. Don't forget to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for free to see more from me. These amazing people here are my channel members and patrons, and a big thank you to them for supporting the channel. If you'd like to support the channel by becoming a channel member or a patron, then check out the links down in the description. In return, you'll get things like early access to my videos and some bonus content too. I want a shout out like these guys got. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.